गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू दी ऑनलाइन क्लासेस इन फिजिक्स फॉर स्टैंडर्ड 12th। इफ यू रिमेंबर लास्ट क्लास वी हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट कैपेसिटर्स, कैपेसिटेंस, सीरीज कॉम्बिनेशन एंड पैरेलल कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ रेजिस्टर्स। बिफोर प्रोसीडिंग फर्दर, लेट मी गिव सम टाइम इन डिस्कसिंग विथ यू How do we recognize whether given capacitors are in series or in parallel? Are there some combinations wherein the capacitors are neither in series nor in parallel? Is such a situation also possible? We'll see them today in this class. So the simplest combination for series combination of two capacitors is this. We said these two capacitors are in series if they are connected like so. One of the plates of the capacitor first is connected to the other plate of capacitor second, and their remaining plates are connected to the battery. Here we can connect a battery. The battery will supply the charges. Now remember, in series combination there is only one path. Most crucial point, there is exactly one path for charge to flow. The positive terminal, suppose it sends plus Q charge to the circuit. The negative terminal would send then negative Q charge like so. The opposite terminals of the battery, remember students, will give equal and opposite charges. They will supply equal and opposite charges. Even in circuits, if this battery is not represented, you can keep in mind, from one side we'll get positive charge, from other side we'll get negative charge. Suppose here the charge is plus Q, here the charge must be minus Q if they are in series. And we have discussed in the last class, here the charge will be minus Q, here the charge will be plus Q. If we have one more capacitor in series, again we'll have plus Q, minus Q charge and so on. What are the important points in series? First point, there should be only one path for charge to flow. Second, charge on each capacitor will remain same. You should put in your own words. I'm just discussing in brief. On each capacitor, irrespective of their capacitances, C1 and C2 might be different, but on them the charges will be same, Q and Q. And I have told you earlier, students, the net charge on the capacitor is zero. But whenever we say that Q is the charge on the capacitor, it means one of the plates has charge plus Q, other plate has charge minus Q. And the third point is that the potential difference across the combination, the potential difference is same as potential difference of the battery. Suppose we write it as V. So the potential difference V across the battery is divided among the capacitors. Suppose here the potential difference is V1, here the potential difference is V2, then we shall write V is equal to V1 plus V2. Always remember these three points. If these three conditions are satisfied, then we will say that the capacitors are in series. Is it clear, students? Next, we shall discuss about parallel combination of capacitors. Two capacitors are said to be connected in parallel if one plates of both the capacitors are connected together. You can see these are the two capacitors. Their left plates are connected together to the same point. Let me call this point as A. And their right plates are also connected to the same point, say B. Suppose we have five capacitors and their left plates are connected to point A and their right plates are connected to point B, same points. If all the capacitors are connected between same two points, then we will say they are in parallel. Here you see, this capacitor is connected between say point A and B, but the other capacitor is connected between points B and C. So it has different pairs for points, but here both the capacitors are connected between same two points. So this is condition number one. So for parallel we can write all capacitors are connected between same two points. Is Is it clear, students? Whatever be the number of capacitors, all of them should be connected between same two points. Secondly, suppose we assume a battery to be connected between these two points. As I have discussed here, this battery will send charges plus Q and minus Q. Suppose it sends plus Q charge this way, minus Q charge this way. This plus Q charge has an option to flow through the two bifurcated paths. Here I told there is only one path, but here there is a choice for the charge. The charge will remain Q till this point when it flows. After this point, it will distribute itself between the two capacitors or among different capacitors if we have more than two capacitors. So here, charge distribution takes place. That means alternative paths are present. There are choices. Alternative paths are there. Here there is only one path for the charge to flow. Here many paths are possible for the charge to flow. The different capacitors will have different charges. Because I have already discussed, charge will distribute itself. Charge distributes itself between the capacitors. And regarding potential difference, since all the capacitors are connected between the same two points, and between the same points A and B, you have connected the battery, so the potential difference V of the battery is nothing but equal to VA minus VB. This V is nothing but VA minus VB, but that is also equal to potential difference across capacitor 1, which I call as V1, and this I'll call as V2. So V1 is equal to V2 is equal to V is equal to VA minus VB. So you should compare these two things carefully. Please pause, think for these two combinations sincerely in your mind. You will be able to grasp the concept of series and parallel combination. If you have understood these two, let's see this particular example. Here we have five capacitors C1, C2, C3, C4 and C5 connected as shown in the figure. Suppose I ask you to find net capacitance between points A and C. I could have assigned some values, but I just want to discuss how to identify series and parallel combinations, if any. Suppose this is the question. You have to find net capacitance between the points A and C. The most important thing is first to identify between which two points you are asked the capacitance. So you have to find equivalent capacitance between A and C. So I can write A and C like this. Those two points between which you have to find the capacitance, those two points, you can imagine it in your mind to be connected to a battery. This you don't have to draw, just you have to keep in mind. That battery will have some potential difference V, and it would send some positive charge plus Q and some negative charge minus Q as shown. Always remember, an imaginary battery should connect between which two points? Those two points between which you have to find the net capacitance. So here it was A and C, so I have connected the battery between points A and C. This positive charge Q sent by the battery will reach as Q till point A. No doubt in that. But after point A, it will divide itself into three paths. Some part Q1 will be developed on capacitor C1, some part, say Q4, will develop on C4, and some other part, that will be Q minus Q1 plus Q4, will develop on C5. Why I wrote this much? Because the total charge was Q. Out of Q, Q1 has come here, Q4 has come here, so how much will be remaining? This total Q minus sum of these two. So Q minus Q1 plus Q4. Is it clear, students? Now this, if it is Q1, this will be how much? Minus Q1. Again, this will be plus Q1. Then this will be minus Q1. So these two capacitors, C1 and C2, you can see there is only one path, as I have discussed here. So C1 and C2 are in series. So I'll redraw this figure like so. This is C1, this is C2. and this was the point B. You can see. So A and C I have drawn here. This is point B. A to B, there was C1. B to C, there is C2. And between A and C, there is C5. Between A and C, I can draw C5. So C1 and C2 are in series. C5, there is only one capacitor. Likewise, this side also, you can see, this is Q4. So this will be minus Q4. Again, this will be plus Q4. This will be minus Q4. So these two capacitors, C4 and C3, you see there is only one path. That's why they are also in series. So C4 and C3. And A and C, you can connect an imaginary battery, which we I have discussed. So this combination can be redrawn like this. Now it is easy to see that these two are in series. C1 and C2 are also in series. And we are left with C5. C1 and C2 are in series, so their equivalent capacitance will be, suppose, C12. So how do you find it? 1 by C12 is equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2. So this I will replace by, and from this we can calculate C12. So this will be our C12. C12 is the equivalent capacitance for the capacitor C1 and C2. Likewise, C4 and C3, they are in series, so their equivalent capacitance I am writing as C3, 4. Now these three capacitors are connected between same points A and C as I have discussed here. That means they are having what kind of connection? They are connected in parallel. So C3, 4, C5 and C1, 2 are connected in parallel. Therefore the net capacitance for this combination between points A and C, so C between A and C will be how much? C1, 2. Plus C5 plus C3, 4. Is it clear, students, how to do? Let me discuss what would happen if we have some other points, combination of points. Now suppose we have the same figure. I give some values to these capacitors. This is 2 microfarad, 2 microfarad, 2 microfarad. This is 1 microfarad, this is 1 microfarad. I have discussed just now, students, how to find the equivalent capacitance between points A and C. Please use that concept to find net capacitance in this particular question. Please take it as a homework. You have to find equivalent capacitance between A and C as per the method which I have discussed earlier for this particular question. In the same question, I am changing the pair of points between which we have to find capacitance. Instead of A and C, suppose we have to find capacitance between points A and D, or likewise it can be any other point. So see, just looking at the figure, it's not sufficient to tell about net capacitance. It's most important thing that one must specify, you are finding the equivalent capacitance between which two points. So here we have to find the capacitance between points A and D. So what I have told, between the points A and D, you imagine a battery. This you don't have to draw, just you have to imagine. It will send plus Q charge, minus Q charge. Plus Q charge will distribute itself. Minus Q charge will distribute here. Now out of that plus Q, something will go here. But whatever it goes here, suppose here it goes Q dash. Then this will be minus Q dash. Now this is only one path. As long as the path remains only one, those capacitors will be in series. So this is Q dash minus Q dash. Again, this will be Q dash. This will be minus Q dash. So C1 and C2, they will be in series, students. So their equivalent capacitance, which I can write as C12, how will you find? 1 by C12 is equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2. So how much will we get? 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2, that is 1. So C12 is equal to how much? 1 microfarad. So in the same question, I'll be doing it. So C12, so first of all, we argued that C1 and C2 are in series. That's why their equivalent capacitance is 1 microfarad. So C1 and C2, this combination I'll now replace like so. And this is how much? C12. And what is its value? 1 microfarad. So that combination I have replaced. Now you see C12 and this capacitor between A and C, that is C5. C5 is connected between A and C, and C12 is also connected between these two points, that is A and C. So what kind of combination are these two? They are in parallel. Since they are in parallel, so next step is, this is first step, then second step, C12 and C5, they are in parallel. Since they are in parallel, their equivalent capacitance between points A and C. So let their equivalent capacitance be CAC. Why I wrote CAC? Because these two capacitors are connected between points A and C. If you wish, you can use some other symbol, it's up to you. How will you find this? So C between points A and C will be C12 plus C5. C12 is how much? 1. This is how much? 1. 1 plus 1, 2 microfarad we will get as the answer. So these two I can replace by 2 microfarad. This is 2 microfarad and I have called it as CAC. Is it clear, students? Now we are left with 3 capacitors and we have to find the capacitance between points A and D. Now you can see, if some charge comes here, it will come here and remaining will go there. The charge Q will distribute itself into these two paths. But whatever charge flows here, same charge has to flow through C3. So now we will say that CAC and C3, they are in series. Is it clear, students? So this is one path. Always you have to start from one point and you have to end at the other point. The given points are A and D. So you have to start from A and you have to end at D. So while going from A to D, this is an isolated path. So CAC and C3, they are in series. There is no alternative path. And this is one capacitor left, so no problem. Now these two are in series. So what will be their equivalent capacitance? Their equivalent capacitance will be, suppose C dash. So C dash is suppose equivalent capacitance of CAC and C3. So how will you find C dash? 1 by C dash will be 1 by this plus 1 by this. So 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2. So that becomes 1, and therefore C dash is how much? 1 microfarad. So this 2 will replace again by how much? 1 microfarad. Now it's clear that this 1 microfarad and this 1 microfarad, they are in parallel. So the net capacitance CAD will be how much? 1 plus 1, that is 2 microfarad as the answer. They are in parallel, so we'll have CAD is equal to C dash plus C4. C dash is 1 microfarad, C4 is also 1 microfarad. Our answer is 2 microfarad. In this way, students, in the given combination, if series and parallel combinations are present, you have to identify them carefully. And for the same figure, if you choose different points, then the equivalent capacitance will be different for different pairs of points. Next, let us discuss one example from your textbook NCERT. This is 2.9. There is a combination of 4 capacitors, like so. The points are given as A, B, C, D. Between points A and D, a potential difference of 500 volt is applied. And these capacitors, all of them have same value of capacitance, that is 10 microfarad. You have to find two things. First, you have to find equivalent capacitance. Second, on each of the capacitors, you have to find the charge. So number A, we have to find equivalent capacitance. Now based on our previous discussion, it's clear. Here you can assume it to be plus, minus, doesn't matter. No need to write these things. So it will send some charge, plus Q charge. That plus Q charge will divide itself into two paths. Out of Q, something will, suppose the total charge is Q. Suppose total charge is Q. Here it will send minus Q charge. Out of charge Q, small Q goes here. Then what will be the charge on this C4? Q minus Q. Law of conservation of charge. Now if this is Q, this will be minus Q. And it is clear that there is only one path for this A, B, C, D. So this C1, this C2 and this C3 are in series. So Q minus Q, again plus Q, then minus Q, again plus Q, and then minus Q. So C1, C2, C3 are in series. So their equivalent capacitance I can write as C123. the combination of 1, 2, 3. First you should write, I am not writing the language. How will you find C1, 2, 3? Because they are in series. 1 by C1, 2, 3 will be 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3. So 1 by 10, 1 by 10, 1 by 10, that is 3 by 10. And therefore C1, 2, 3 will be reciprocal of that, that is 10 by 3 microfarad. Now that combination C12, this combination, now I can redraw it like this. So this is A, this is D. Between A and D there is C4, and between A and D these three capacitors I can replace by C123, and this potential difference is how much? 500 volts. Is it okay? Now these two capacitors are clearly connected in parallel. Both of them are connected between same points A and D. So this is 10 microfarad and this is 10 by 3 microfarad. Therefore equivalent capacitance C equivalent will be how much? C4 plus C1 to 3. So C4 is 10 and that is 10 by 3. So this gives 30 plus 40 by 3 microfarad as the answer. Now, so we have got this C equivalent is 40 by 3 microfarad. Now we have to find the charges on the capacitors. To find charges on the capacitors, different methods can be used. Just I am discussing. You can use your own method also. You see the capacitor C4. You concentrate on capacitor C4. This capacitor has a value how much of capacitance? 10 microfarad. So we know its capacitance. And it is connected between points A and D. What is the potential difference between points A and D? See, A is connected to this point, D is connected to this point, and potential difference is 500 volts. So this potential difference is 500 volt. So we will use the concept Q is equal to CV. But here, what is the charge? It's not Q, it's Q minus Q. So Q minus Q, that is the charge on capacitor C4, is how much? That capacitance, that is C4, times this potential difference, that is 500 volt. So C4 is how much? C4 is 10 microfarad, that means 10 into 10 to the power minus 6 farad, and V is 500. So this will give you 5 into 10 to the power 2, 10 power 3, and 3 minus 6 is minus 3 coulombs. So Q minus Q is 5 into 10 to the power minus 3 coulomb. Therefore, charge on capacitor C4 is equal to how much? 5 millicoulomb, you can say. 5 into 10 to the power minus 3 coulomb. Step number 1. Next, I'll find total charge. The total charge is how much that I have taken as Q. What is total capacitance? This much. What is total potential difference? 500. So I can use this formula. The total charge sent by the battery, that Q is equal to C times V. So this will become C equivalent is 40 by 3 and V is, 40 by 3 microfarad. So I'll multiply it by 10 to the power minus 6 and then V is how much? 500. So this much coulomb. So this will become something, millicoulomb, coulomb, whatever you want. So you'll get total charge. Out of this Q, something has come appeared across C4. Remaining has appeared across C1, C2 and C3. How do you find that? This minus this. Q minus Q will be how much? Q. So total, you should have done this first. Step number 8, total charge we have found. Out of total charge on C4, no need to write these things. Okay, because I have written, no problem. Step number A, total charge we have found. Step number B, we have found charge on capacitor C4. And then step number C, charge on C123, this combination. But whatever charge C123 has, same charges this C1, this C2 and this C3 will have, because they are connected in series. And in series combination, you know, the charges on the capacitors remain same. So charge on C123, that is C1, C2 and C3, will be the total charge Q minus the charge on capacitor C4, that is Q minus Q. This becomes how much? This value you put minus 5 millicoulomb. calculation you can do your yourself. This will give you the answer for charges on the different capacitors. So please practice this numerical properly. I don't think there should be any problem in this particular question. I told some more methods can be applied. So you try to do it by this method. I will discuss one more idea using which you can find these charges. So charge on C4, that so charge on C4 I'll write as Q4, Q1, Q2, Q3 I can write, or you can leave it as same also that we have discussed earlier. So charge on Q4 I have discussed, Q4 is equal to C4 into V4 or V, clear? So this we have already calculated, this remains same. For finding charges on these capacitors, you know that all these three capacitors are in series, so the charges on them must be same. So plus Q minus Q, plus Q minus Q, plus Q minus Q, like so. This combination is connected between points A and D. So potential difference between points A and D is nothing but VA minus VD. And how much is this potential difference? That is given in the question as 500 volts. Now VA minus VD I can write as VA minus VB, plus VB minus VC, plus VC minus VD. Can I write so? And this total becomes how much? 500. You can see VB will cancel, VC will cancel, we will be left with VA minus VD. Now what is VA minus VB? VA minus VB is the potential difference across first capacitor C1. You know that Q is equal to C into V, so V will be equal to how much? Q upon C. So for this capacitor, first capacitor, the potential difference VA minus VB will be how much? Q upon C. What is the charge on this capacitor? Q. And what is its capacitance? C1. C1 is how much? 10 microfarad. That means 10 into 10 to the power minus 6. Plus VB minus VC likewise will be Q by 10 into 10 to the power minus 6. Plus VC minus VD will be how much? Q upon 10 into 10 to the power minus 6. And this comes out to be total 500 volts. So Q you can take common, or these three terms are same. So 3 times this much is equal to 500, and that will give you the value of Q. There is one more technique, but I'll stop here. You can try it yourself. Next, I will discuss an important topic before stopping today. That how do we calculate energy stored in a capacitor? First, how come there is some energy? So remember students, whenever there is some field, whether it is gravitational field, electric field, magnetic field, there is associated energy density in that particular field. So here the energy is stored in the electric field, region of electric field between the plates of capacitor. Suppose these two are the plates of capacitor, okay? And they have been charged. The charge over one of them is suppose plus Q and this is minus Q. So it is positively charged and this is negatively charged. And the charge here, as I told, this is suppose plus Q, this is suppose minus Q. Then you know in between the region, in between the plates of the capacitor, there is electric field. That electric field value also, you know, it is sigma upon epsilon naught. In this region of electric field between the plates of the capacitor, there is some energy, and of course that is electrostatic energy. We have to find this energy. The concept for finding this energy is that initially we start with uncharged plates. Charge is zero on both the plates. These are the plates of the capacitor, and we take its capacitance to be how much? C. It has not been charged, so there is no electric field. E is equal to zero, and there is no energy, of course. There is no electrostatic energy. Electrostatic energy we will denote by capital U, so that is also zero. So this is initial condition. When the charges are not present. Next, what we do in steps of delta Q dash, charge is transferred from one plate B to other plate A. See, they are neutral. We take some positive charge. This is positive. We assume this to be positive. Delta Q dash is greater than 0. We take a small amount of positive charge, delta Q dash, from this and we transfer it to other plate. This is first step. Second step, again we take more delta Q dash from here, we transfer it here. Delta Q dash from here. So we go on shifting charge delta Q dash from plate B to plate A in steps. Because this positive charge is being taken from plate B, it will develop negative charge. And this positive charge accumulates on plate A, it will develop what kind of charge? Positive charge. After a series of steps, suppose it develops charge plus Q dash, and this develops charge minus Q dash. Am I clear to you, students? So in steps of delta Q dash, we are shifting charges from B to A. After some steps, this has developed some charge, that value is how much? Plus Q dash. And equal amount of negative charge piles up on plate B. Now since this is positive, since this is negative, there is some potential difference between them, there is some electric field between them. Let the potential difference between them be V. When we bring charge delta Q dash, we have to do some work, because that charge delta Q dash being positive will be repelled by Q dash and attracted by minus Q dash. So we have to push it towards this plate A, so we have to do some work in bringing it. And we go on doing this till the charges on these two plates increase from initial value 0 to final value plus Q and minus Q. When we attain this state, we will stop and then we will calculate how much work has been done by us. That work done will be equal to potential energy between the plates of the capacitor. In this situation, suppose plus Q dash, now charges are not 0, plus Q dash and minus Q dash. Capacitance is how much? C. Potential difference is how much? V. So we know that Q is equal to CV. So charge on the capacitor is how much? Q dash. Capacitance is how much? C. Potential difference is how much? V. Now in the next step, again, what we do? We bring charge delta Q dash. So in the next step, charge delta Q dash is brought from where to where? From B to A. During this step, the work done we write as delta W. So we know that work done is equal to charge into potential difference. How much charge we are taking? Delta Q dash. And how much potential difference is there? V. Is it okay? Instead of delta, I should have used dq, students. So let me change this symbol everywhere. Differential value of charge, very very small amount of charge. I have to make these charges very small and hence number of steps will become very large. So work done in bringing charge dq dash, so the steps are not of delta q dash, it is of dq dash. So the work done in bringing charge dq dash from B to A is equal to dWL, right? dW is equal to charge into potential difference, charge is this much, potential difference is V. But how much is V? You can see this equation. So this becomes dq dash into V is how much? Q dash upon C. This is the small work done in one step. Therefore the total work done in charging the capacitor, is total work done, will write as W is equal to integration of this value, that is Q dash upon C dQ dash, where Q dash will be from initial value. Initial value of Q dash was 0 and final value of this was Q. We have to charge till Q. So C is constant, it will come out. We will be left with integration Q dash dQ dash. You know integration x dx is x square by 2. So this becomes Q dash square upon 2. And the limits are from 0 to q. So this becomes q dash is equal to q will put, so q square upon 2c. So that is the answer to the energy stored in the capacitor. So we can write this work done. So this work done gets stored as electrostatic potential energy between the plates of capacitor. So that energy we write as capital U, that is how much, q square upon 2c. So this is our answer. So what we have discussed, in between the plates of the capacitor there is an electric field. That electric field is how much? Sigma upon epsilon naught. That sigma is nothing but q upon a epsilon naught, number one. And second thing we discussed today, that is the electrostatic potential energy between the plates of the capacitor is given as how much? Q square upon 2c. Now this can be written in different forms. You know q is equal to cv, so q square becomes c square v square. We are using this relation. The q is cv, so q square is this much upon 2c. So cc cancels. This is equal to how much? Half cv square. You can also put c is equal to q by v. C is q by v. So q will cancel. Half qv. So any of these three formulae can be used as per the need. So remember this, the total potential energy, electrostatic potential energy between the plates of capacitor is q square upon 2c, that is equal to half cv square, and that is equal to half qv. So this is electrostatic potential energy or electrostatic energy between the plates of the capacitor. There is a term called electrostatic energy density. This will denote by small u. You know mass density is mass per unit volume. Likewise, energy density is energy per unit volume. So energy density between the plates of the capacitor is energy per unit volume. Now what is our energy? Our energy is q square upon 2c. And what is the volume? Volume of this region. Now how do you find that? See, the two plates, suppose we take them to be rectangular or square, their area of cross section is suppose A and this distance is suppose D. So then this volume, that volume will be how much? That will be area of cross section multiplied by this thickness D. So A into D. Now this can be simplified. You see students, this Q can be written as E times A times epsilon naught. So Q square becomes E square A square epsilon naught square divided by 2. Now capacitance is given by the formula for parallel plate capacitor, A epsilon naught upon D. So D I am writing here, or no problem, A epsilon naught upon D, and then into AD. So what things will cancel? You can see, so this D and this D will cancel, this A will cancel. So what will be left? Half. So one more A will cancel here. Then there is epsilon naught that will cancel. So what will be left? Half. Then one epsilon naught will be left. So U is equal to half epsilon naught and then square of E. Very important formula. So remember this formula, this is the energy. So its unit will be joules, SI unit. And this is energy density. So its unit should be energy per unit volume, so joules per meter cube. And before leaving, just last one important note. This formula is an universal formula. We have derived this for a special case of parallel plate capacitor, but in any region of any kind of electric field, wherever there is electric field, in that electric field there is an energy density given as U is equal to half epsilon naught E square. Commit to memory. You should memorize this particular formula. Let me repeat. Wherever in any region there is some electric field, in that region the electrical energy density will be U is equal to half epsilon naught E square, epsilon naught value you know, E is the magnitude of electric field. Okay students, I'll stop here and see you in the next class with some questions to discuss from NCERT. Thank you, till then, take care and read well.